Tell you, folks, I thought I had a hard day yesterday. I thought I had a real hard day yesterday. But it must have been a really hard day at the New Yorker. Or a really hard day at the New Yorker. I know this made headlines, but let's be honest here. Jeffrey Toobin has been tooting his own horn for a long time. Now, this guy, everybody's worried that Toobin is going to take the Biden story off the front page. No, Toobin is considered one of these guys. Toobin is a left-wing commentator on CNN. Toobin had an affair with Jeff Greenfield's daughter and knocked her up and then asked her to go get an abortion. So yesterday, they're doing a simulation at the New Yorker, a Zoom simulation, and somehow Jeffrey Toobin, in the middle of a hard day, is caught masturbating on camera on Zoom. He said, "I forgot. I didn't know." He turned the camera down, his laptop lid, turned it down, stood up, and there it was for everybody to see. So my question is, what are these liberals doing masturbating in front of each other on a Zoom call at the New Yorker? I mean, these people are nuts. They run around talking about how we or whatever we are, what they say we are. Meanwhile, these people running around doing a voting seminar while masturbating on a Zoom call. I know, look, it could be an attempt. Take the heat off Biden. Jeffrey Toobin figured if he lifted his own lid, making all kinds of news, Biden wouldn't have to lift his lid and answer a single question about Hunter. But they need to send a thank you note to Jeffrey Toobin. They really do. Toobin, a master debater from way back, took attention away from the Biden-Crame family for a news cycle. Now, if CNN, MSNBC, ABC, CBS, NBC can just get one of their anchors or analysts every day to do what Jeffrey Toobin did and do it up until Election Day, maybe the country will be distracted from the shocking corruption of Joe Big Guy Biden's family. That ought to be Trump's first question, by the way, at the debate. Are you the big guy? Are you the big guy? They'll mute his microphone the minute he does that. Are you the big guy? You know, who knows how these things affect voters, really? Is something that Jeffrey Toobin does because he's so tightly associated with the left. He's so tightly associated with the Bidens. He's tight with the Democrat Party. He wants it that way. It has been that way. CNN ditto. So let's forget Toobin for just a second. Can we eliminate the Michael Jackson tune there? For like we made the point. What the heck was this simulation call over? Why would they be play acting on a Zoom call? Is this what leftists do for fun? Why would a magazine staff be doing this? Well, Jeffrey Toobin was masturbating in front of New Yorker bigs, report says. Now he's the talk of the town. New Yorker writer, CNN analyst Jeffrey Toobin didn't just expose himself during a Zoom work meeting. He was allegedly caught masturbating in the call with some of the magazine's biggest names. He's now been suspended from the publication. I don't think CNN has a problem with this. They have not suspended. Have you heard? I don't think they have a problem at all. I think they're probably applauding it. I think CNN, oh, yeah, this is great stuff. He said, "I made an embarrassingly stupid mistake believing I was off camera." The 60-year-old married Harvard Law School grad said in a stunning admission to Vice, which broke news of the incident on Monday. "I believed I was off camera on a Zoom call. I believed that I was not visible on Zoom. I thought no one on the Zoom call could see me. I thought I had muted the Zoom video. Who mutes video? I apologize to my wife, I apologize to my family, I apologize to my friends and co-workers, and I apologize to the Bidens. He didn't say that, but you know he's thinking it. Oh, is that right, CNN put him on leave? When did that happen? A couple hours ago, I missed, they put him, is it interminable leave, 2 weeks leave, or just split the scene for a while we let the heat blow. Oh, he asked for some time off, right? He's got to go out and learn how to use Zoom, obviously. He muted the video, and it didn't get muted. Two people on the video call told Vice that the virtual gathering... Now, this is where this gets curious to me. Two people on the video call told Vice the virtual gathering, the Zoom call, was part of an election simulation last week that included New Yorker notables like Jane Mayer, Evan Osnos, Masha Gessen, and Jelani Cobb, as well as producers from the magazine and WNYC Public Radio. What is an election simulation at the New Yorker? What I can't fathom what does the New Yorker do on election night? What an election simulation. The two sources said that at one point it looked as if Toobin was taking another call and lowered his camera, and that's when they saw him getting to work on himself. It was unclear what, if anything, others on the virtual call saw. Now, during the simulation, Osnos had been playing the role of Joe Biden. Gessen was President Trump. Jane Mayer represented establishment Republicans, and she wouldn't know how to portray establishment Republicans if her life depended on it. And this Cobb babe, Jelani Cobb, stood in for the Democrats. Toobin was supposed to be playing the part of the courts, while Andrew Marantz represented the far right, Sue Halpern was the left, and Dexter Filkin stood in for the military. Anybody have any idea what this could possibly have been? An election simulation? Were they simulating what happens if Biden wins, then doing a simulation of what happens if Trump wins? This is a very, very strange bunch of people, folks. We've known this. This is a very, very strange thing for these people to be. And remember, they think they are the brightest in the room. They think they're special. They think they are, in fact, elitists. Now grab audio soundbite number two. This is great. There is this is, I think, a great reaction to this whole New Yorker story and Toobin and all that. Recently on YouTube, Turning Point USA Ambassador Alexandra Lanes posted a video explaining why people are voting for President Trump.